Well, my early life was being raised in a Christian family. We went to church every week. My father taught a Sunday school class, and we went to every youth camp. From outside, it would appear that we had a great family. But in reality, life was pretty far from perfect. We did attend church. We'd put on clothes that looked nice, clothes that we wouldn't wear any other time. We would wear smiles that we wouldn't wear any other time as well. I learned that church was a place where you went and pretended that things were better than they really were. This all changed when I was around 10 years old. My father moved out, my parents got a divorce. Life after that was pretty tough. The main rule of the house at the time was not to let anyone know how bad it is at home. My mother turned to addiction, and life really was tough. In time, she ended up finding a boyfriend, and my dad took us to court and proved my mom to be an unfit mother. This was around the time I was 14. At that point, we were pulled out of the house and we moved to El Paso to be with him. By the time I was 16, I was on my own, hitchhiking around, done dropped out of school, and pretty much living here, there, and a little bit of nowhere. I was on the streets and learning to make it on my own. Well, at 17, I decided to join up with the military, and I had my father come sign the paperwork to get me into the military at 17. Made it into there, and I thought I'd found a direction in my life. Well, in time, as life goes on, a good friend of mine was killed, and I couldn't see much in my life that was worth living. I didn't like my life, so I was seeking refuge for myself through drugs, alcohol. There wasn't a whole lot of drugs I wouldn't do. And in time, addiction got a hold of me. I had to have them to just get up in the morning. It was then that, in time, the state of Texas decided that I'd had enough chances in life and I needed to go serve some time. So I got a 6-year sentence for possession of crack cocaine. I ended up serving 3 years on that sentence. I started to read my Bible more, started to get closer to God. And that was pretty much where I decided to turn my life around, is when I was locked up in prison. And I got out, was seeking to know more about God. Still am. I don't understand God, but I can tell you how God has worked in my life, how he's pulled me out of addiction and out of prison and given me a second chance with life. It's made it possible for me to find a wife, have children, be a good father. You know, things that I never would have dreamed of in my life when I was young, as I was growing up, he's made possible in my life. And you know, when people say there's no evidence of God, I can say I'm standing right here. I am the evidence, you know, and you can't convince me otherwise, because I was at a point in my life where I couldn't stop the drugs. When we follow his plans, when we can not be so arrogant as to say we understand God and we know what it is, but we fall and we are able to accept his authority as king in our lives, that's when our lives can change. So as I go through and I meet people who are in addiction now, as I meet people who are, you know, growing up and experiencing bad family relations, as I go around and I see people who are on the streets, I can relate with those people. And it's not by hiding the things I've done in my past. It's not by not showing the scars from my past. It's through those scars that I can show the work of God in my life and how he has taken me and made me into a new creature. And that is amazing evidence in of itself. This new creature in Christ is someone who you can stand to be around. At one point in my life, people paid people to keep me locked in a cell and to make sure I didn't get out of there. And now, people come to me for advice. It's an amazing transformation to see how God has worked in my life and how far I've come. And I'm not saying that I've done it great, and I'm not saying I'm a good person, but God is great. And the way he can work in my life is amazing. that he could take someone like I was and turn him into somebody like I am. And I just can't wait to see what tomorrow brings and who he's going to turn me into in time. And each one of us has gone through something. You don't have to be pulled out of prison to be a good witness to God. But we all have something in our lives where he's worked in our lives, and we can share that with others. It's not by hiding who we are and our faults. It's by sharing our accomplishments and how he's guided us over our faults. That's how lives get changed.